क्वालिटी सीरीज का नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज करेक्ट रिगार्डिंग द रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट ऑफ 1773? वन, इट मेड द गवर्नर्स ऑफ बॉम्बे एंड मद्रास प्रेसिडेंसीज सबॉर्डिनेट टू द बंगाल प्रेसिडेंसी. सेकेंड, इट एम्पावर्ड द गवर्नर जनरल इन काउंसिल टू फ्रेम रेगुलेशंस फॉर द प्रोविंशियल कोर्ट्स एंड काउंसिल्स. विच ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट्स इज आर करेक्ट? सो आंसर है ए, स्टेटमेंट टू वॉज फीचर ऑफ द एक्ट ऑफ सेटलमेंट विच वॉज ब्रॉट एज एन Amendment to Regulating Act 1773. Next, which of the following is correct regarding the Pitt's India Act? The Board of Control was created to manage commercial functions. Second, companies' territories were called British possessions in India. Answer B, the Court of Directors managed the commercial functions. The Board of Control managed the political functions. Next, consider the following statements regarding the Charter Act of 1883, which of the statements is are correct? One, deprived the governors of Bombay and Madras of their legislative functions. Second, laws made under this act were called acts. Third, it separated the legislative and executive functions of the Governor General's Council. Which of the statements is are correct? Answer hamara A hai. The separation of legislative and executive functions happened in the Charter Act of 1853. It is also known as St. Helena Act 1833 or Government of India Act 1833. Control of the island of St. Helena was transferred from the East India Company to the Crown. It was passed by the British Parliament to renew the Charter Act 1813 of the East India Company. This act renewed the charter of the East India Company for 20 years. The East India Company was deprived of its commercial privileges. The company's monopoly over the trade except for tea and trade with China was ended as a result of laissez-faire and the continental system of Napoleon Bonaparte. Features of Charter Act of 1833. 1. Office of Governor General. The Governor General of Bengal became the Governor General of India with exclusive legislative powers. The presidencies of Bombay and Madras were deprived of their legislative powers. The Governor General of India was given civil and military powers. The Government of India was created for the first time, having the authority over the entire territorial area possessed by the British in India. The first Governor General of India was Lord William Bentinck. Second, Governor General Council. The members of the Governor General's Council were reduced by the Pitt's India Act 1784, was again increased to four. The fourth member has very limited powers. He was not entitled to act as a member of the council except for legislative purposes. The Governor General Council had the authority to amend, repeal or alter any law in the entire length and breadth of India for any British, foreigner or Indian administrative body, EIC. The activities of East India Company as a commercial body came to an end. The company purely became an administrative body. The company's territories in India were to be held by it in trust for His Majesty, His heirs and successors. Attempt to open civil services. The act attempted to introduce a system of open competition for selection in civil services. It stated that Indians should not be debarred from holding any place, office and employment under the company. It was nullified after opposition from the Court of Directors. The concept of a merit-based modern civil service in India was introduced on the recommendations of Lord Macaulay's report in 1854-3. Legal British Colony. The act permitted the English to settle freely in India. It effectively legalized British colonization of India. Fourth, ended slavery. The slavery existed in India at that time. The act provided for the mitigation of slavery in India. The slavery was abolished by British Parliament in Britain and its possessions in 1833. Fourth, Law Commission. The Indian Law Commission was established in 1833 and Lord Macaulay was made its first chairman. It aimed to codify all kinds of law in India. The act provided that the laws made in India were supposed to be laid in British Parliament. Significance of the act. This act was a watershed moment for the constitutional and political history of India. It elevated the Governor General of Bengal as Governor General of India and consolidated and centralized the administration of India. It made the East India Company a trustee of the Crown in the field of administration. The act provided to freely admit Indians into administration in the country. The act separated the legislative functions of the Governor General and Council from executive functions. The Law Commission under Lord Macaulay codified the laws. Next, consider